Hi everyone, Paul from UltimateFatBurner.com here, and today we're going to look at soy and its connection to estrogen and whether that's something you need to be concerned about. I'll be right back at you in just a couple of seconds. Stick around, don't you dare go anywhere. All right, welcome back. So let's talk about soy and let's talk about estrogen. What's the deal? What's going on? Is it nonsense? Is it not nonsense? What do you really need to know? Well, soy and soy products contain three isoflavones called genistein, daidzein, and glycine. These isoflavones are also known as phytoestrogens, which are plant compounds which mimic the female hormone estrogen. Guys, if you've ever found yourself trying on your girlfriend's clothes or watching The Notebook after a big feed of tofu and soy milk, this is why. Okay, that was silly, and I am only kidding. But it actually cuts to the chase about the concern with soy products. And that is that these estrogen-mimicking compounds can interfere with the normal function of hormones in the body and as a result have negative effects on all sorts of things, including reproductive hormone levels and sperm counts in men. In addition, some animal studies show that these compounds can also cause breast cancer, and in human studies, some women who supplemented with soy protein saw an increase in the number of epithelial cells in the breasts, which is important because these are the cells that are most likely to turn cancerous. To make things even more confusing, some observational studies suggest women who consume soy and soy products actually have a lower risk of breast cancer. So as a result of this, you'll hear all sorts of things about soy and soy products, that they are essentially poison and toxic and you shouldn't eat them and blah, 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 blah. And on the other hand, you have folks telling you that there's nothing to worry about. Soy is wholesome, it's healthy. People have been eating soy and living happily ever after, dancing merrily in fields for hundreds of years. The truth is that the science on the dangers of soy consumption is conflicting and contradictory, and there's not enough conclusive evidence to suggest whether or not soy consumption presents a real danger, and more importantly, how much is dangerous. For almost every study that you can dig up showing a negative effect, you can find another one to contradict it. Now, I realize that's not particularly helpful, so let me provide some much needed context to the discussion about soy and estrogen. Number one, soy isn't the only food we eat that contains these phytoestrogens we've been talking about. They're common in many other legumes also in our diet. Number two, while humans have certainly eaten soy for hundreds of years, it's only recently that we've gained easy access to foods like soy milk and soy protein, which makes it easy to consume super high, almost concentrated levels of these phytoestrogens. Number three, there's an old saying, it's the dose that makes the poison. In my opinion, that certainly applies here. The occasional use of soy and soy products is not going to hurt you, and it may be beneficial. However, if you drink soy milk regularly, eat tofu, and supplement with a soy-based protein powder on a regular basis, you're more at risk to suffer the side effects and the dangers should they actually turn out to be an issue. And we're not 100% sure yet that they are. So what's the bottom line with soy and estrogen, and what's a practical recommendation for soy consumption? It's pretty simple. Use common sense. My personal recommendation is, you know, don't worry about occasional use of soy products. You know, nothing's gonna happen to you. But I would think carefully about regular repeated use of them, especially those foods that make it really easy to consume a lot of those soy constituents that we're worried about. Soy milk, soy protein powder, things like that. One last point, if you are a new mother or father thinking about a soy-based infant formula, I would suggest you consult with a qualified medical professional before using one. Notwithstanding the phytoestrogens, which can cause issues on their own, soy-based infant formulas contain high levels of manganese that have been tied to ADHD and adverse neurological effects. So please be careful. Okay guys, thanks for watching. If you like this video, it would be really awesome if you could give us a thumbs up. If you have questions or comments, please leave them below. Also, if you haven't subscribed to this channel, please do join us. It would be awesome to have you along for the journey. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you really soon.